Hey everybody, welcome back. It's Charlie. We're doing the Temple 420 Bible study and Torah tour. We're going to celebrate King Solomon as we work out with him every day for a proverb a day. And we are on day three, Proverbs 3. So we're trying to find out what wisdom is. She's beautiful. I bet she smells really good, the scent of a woman, right? Well, think about the Statue of Liberty, as I said, with the crown of thorns and the blazing torch. And flip over in your spare time to Genesis 15 and look at verse 17 and see the covenant between God and Abraham and God and man. Can you believe that you're supposed to smoke pot, serve God in the temple, which is the body, and give him a fragrant offering that reminds him of his son? I do. That's what wisdom is. No tea. Thinking about wisdom and the key, Enki and Enlil goes back a little bit to the Sumerian tablets. My wisdom has been given exactly as Hashem says. If you offer the fragrant offering and you open your mind and let him start to prompt your thoughts, well, he will guide you a different way. So with that, we turn to King Solomon, Proverbs 3. Wisdom bestows well-being. So we have healthy, wealthy, and wise, or the earth. My son, do not forget my teaching. Click, pause, remember the great Mamre tree that Abraham sits under, and your mammary glands for your bosom. And here is the forget and remember part of the rhyme and riddle. If you forget, the aroma and God, your mind, your thought process will make the connection. My son, do not forget my teaching, but keep my commands in your heart, in your bosom, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you peace and prosperity. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. Bind them with the endocannabinoid system and the CB1 and CB2 receivers around your neck. Write them on the tablet scroll of hemp on your heart. Then you will win favor and a good name in the sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all of your ways, submit to him, and he will make your paths straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun evil. This will bring health to your body and nourishment to your bones. Honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruits of all your crops, and then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine. My son, do not despise the Lord's discipline, and do not resent his rebuke, because the Lord disciplines those he loves, as a father disciplines the son he delights in. Blessed are those who find wisdom, those who gain or grain knowledge and understanding, for she is more profitable than silver and yields better returns than gold. She is more precious than rubies. Nothing you desire can compare to her. Long life is in her right hand. In her left hand are riches and honor. Her ways are pleasant ways, and all her paths are peace. She is a tree of life to those who take hold of her. Those who hold fast will be blessed. By wisdom, the Lord laid the earth's foundations. By understanding, he set the heavens in place. By his knowledge, the watery depths were divided, and the clouds let drop the dew. The clouds let drop the dew. My son, do not let wisdom and understanding out of your sight. Preserve sound judgments and discretion. They will be life for you, an ornament to grace your neck. Then you will go on your way in safety, and your foot will not stumble. When you lie down, you will not be afraid. And when you lie down, your sleep will be sweet. Have no fear of sudden disaster or of the ruin that overtakes the wicked. For the Lord will be at your side and will keep your foot from being snared. Do not withhold good from those to whom it is due, when it is in your power to act. Do not say to your neighbor, "Come back tomorrow, I'll give you bread tomorrow," when you already have it within you. Do not plot harm against your neighbor who lives trustfully near you. Do not accuse anyone for no reason when they have done you no harm. Do not envy the violent or choose their ways. For the Lord detests the perverse, but takes the upright into his confidence. The Lord's curse is on the house of the wicked, but he blesses the home of the righteous. He mocks proud mockers, but shows favor to the humble and oppressed. The wise inherit honor, but fools only get shame. Baruch Hashem for Proverbs 3 with King Solomon, and I'll give you the wisdom part for the word shame. It's missing, huh? Shame on you. Or if you put the word together, because it's been word division, you get Hashem. Hemp and hash. What is the offspring? I don't know. Maybe it's cannabis. So there's Proverbs 3. You clearly see the side between God and man, but the middleman is cannabis. It gives you the opening to approach the temple of God and bring an offering that is pleasing and satisfying and food for you and him, the him inside of you. Baruch Hashem. God bless.